The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show.
Live from Boston, Massachusetts, this is Unscheduled with Skymo and The Dave. Here we are again, Dave. I want to thank our military that's deployed all around the world and on the Mexican-American border, Dave. And God bless them and for what they do. And I just pray the Lord just help their families during their times of separation. And I hope they can all get back home, Dave. I hope I live one day long enough to where we don't see nothing but normal deployment. You know, Korea and Germany used to be our normal deployments. Japan got a Marine base over there, and probably some others by now. But, I'd like to see an end to all this deployments. You know, back in the Vietnam War, Dave, you was in during the Vietnam War, last part of it, and I just missed the Vietnam War by a couple of years. But I had everybody that was my trainers, my CEOs and my captains and superiors, most of them was Vietnam vets, and they would... A lot of them would sign up for two tours over there in Nam, and it's like a 16-month deployment. And if you signed up for a third tour, they sent one of my buddies to a psychiatrist. And but now he was a grunt, and he was in the heat of it. He was a tunnel rat over there, and so he never would talk a whole lot about it, but... He said he got to where he thrived on that, and so he wanted to sign up for another hitch, and he ultimately didn't go. They sent him back to the States. But you've got people now, Dave, with multiple deployments, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8 deployments into a combat zone. That's unheard of, man, you know. And, of course, we don't have the size of a military. We don't have no draft. I wish we did. I would like to see, even before you go into college, that's one way to put a stop to these college deferments. Every kid that wants to go to college has to do 2 years in one branch of the service.
See, they have that in Israel and Singapore, that's yeah. National service.
Right.
You have to.
It's
mandatory that you've got no choice. That's the way it should be here, I think.
Well,
everything should be mandatory at least a couple of years so that people know, you know, a little bit about discipline and how the country really works, what makes it work.
Right.
Without the military, it wouldn't last very long.
No. Well, you know, and it's peace through strength. And, from before Alexander the Great to today, they all knew that. All of your great military generals, they all knew that. And
that's the motto of the USS Ronald Reagan, aircraft carrier. That's peace through strength. That's their motto.
But now you look at that's just like today now, Dave. These days, we've got now, you know, I really like General Mathis. And I don't know why him and President Trump fell out. I guess because they wanted to pull out of Syria.
That was only part of it.
You know,
Trump said he was a Democrat.
Yeah,
He can. You know, he's got the right to be a Democrat, but he's also got a right to serve the president and do what the president wants him to do. So, if he didn't want to do it, the best thing to do is get out.
Just leave.
Just instead of getting out and angry and writing a book and.
Yeah.
Tell-all book, whatever.
Right, yeah.
He's an honorable guy, so that's what he did. He just left. I ain't got no problem with it.
Well, see, and I think what happens, now, he was combat vet, and
think he went active 1969.
Yeah.
So he's got me beat by a couple years.
Yeah. Well, see, I think what happens with a lot of your old soldiers like that and the Marines, he was in the service for like 40 years. He was in the Marine Corps. But I think what happens, Dave, now I don't know for sure, this is just my speculation, and from it, I glean this from his comments, because, and other ones too, Dave, in the Pentagon, we've got so, our older military has got so dependent on our allies that they're afraid to stand alone. For some reason, they don't want to make demands of our allies. We just move in and just hand it over, you know, our wealth, our blood, our sweat, our fortune. And Donald Trump comes in. He's making demands on these allies. He's looking at the books. He's looking at the wounded soldiers. He's going into these hospitals, you know, and he's saying, look, there's something wrong here. You know, all of our fortune and our youth is going to this country, and you guys are just reared back on your, in your, you know, elbows, and we're doing all the heavy lifting here. And General Flynn, I think, was another one. I think that these older Marines and the soldiers that's in the Pentagon, the old brass, they don't know how to handle that, David, because, you know, we've always give everybody around the world, we just handed it out, we just shucked it out to them. And they don't know how to deal with Donald Trump. They don't know how to change. And I think that was a lot of friction between the Pentagon and Trump. And not only that, some of our senators, Lindsey Graham. In the beginning, Lindsey Graham was the same way. And we can't be that dependent. Yes, we need some allies, Dave, but
the thing I don't get is why in the world guys like Mitt Romney come along.
Yeah.
He never talked that bad about Obama. If he, like Trump said, if he had talked that bad about Obama, he probably would have won the election. With Republicans like that, who needs Democrats?
Right.
We don't need them. I mean, I just can't figure it out. Why in the world he wants to act that way? And Trump's gave him every chance in the world to come over to his side, and he keeps piping up with these disrespectful words about Trump. I just don't get it. I don't understand why in the world you want to get into a shouting match with Donald Trump when he's the president of the United States and the head of your party. Why not? Why don't you just become an independent or a Democrat?
Right. Yeah. Well, and you know, and that's just like the comment he made today, and said he wasn't up to the task or something like that. I didn't see the comment. Just heard bits and pieces.
Yeah, it's all about you didn't command respect or
or
his character wasn't such that that he should be president.
Right.
He had a bad character. Well, it's bad character
so
to not be on the winning. Be a Republican.
Right.
The Democrats all stand together. Why can't the Republicans all stand together?
Right. And I think that's why a lot of these Republicans are leaving. You notice how a bunch of them are retiring now that they are in the minority in the House. They're just going to take their ball and go home instead of stand here and fight. And that just tells me right there, their heart's not in what's
well, the
best
way,
for
way,
this country.
The way it was set up, though, they couldn't be chairman of their... the Republicans wouldn't let them. They were term limited, so and rather than just go back to being a regular congressman, they just left Congress altogether. So that's one reason they did it.
That's kind of like being a baby, though, don't you think? And if you're useful and you got some pull, but that just tells me one thing.
They love power.
You know, the power is more important than this country to them. Okay, just like Pelosi and just like that rat Schumer, And they had their little sit-down meeting today. And apparently, now, you know, same old. They're not going to give him the money he wants for the wall. And President Trump even told him, hey, let's negotiate. Let's sit down and talk about this. And they're still defiant. They're still wanting to stick their finger in his eye. They're still wanting to turn this around and hang this, in which President Trump said, hey, I'll take the blame for this. You know, I don't care how many national parks they close. I don't care if the Smithsonian stays closed until the doors rust together, okay? And if these are non-essential employees, well, maybe they need to be going somewhere and getting them another job. Maybe this will last long enough to thin out our government, and they'll go find jobs elsewhere, David.
Well, half the people that work in these government jobs, they don't do anything.
We have 4 million, not including the military. We have 4 million, give or take, 4 million employees in our federal government. Our founding fathers would throw gas on that place with them in it and strike a match to it if they knew the shape that this government was in today. I start getting, it upsets me to even think about this stuff, Dave, because, you know, all this stuff is tied to mine and your wealth. You know, the bigger our government gets, local, state, federal, the bigger they get, the more of our own personal wealth that they take. And people need to start realizing that. Well, our wealth is connected to theirs. You know, and it's not theirs. They're stealing it from us.
It's just like Social Security. What they do? They take it out of your check week after week, month after month, year after year, decade after decade. And then when you get old enough to retire like us, then what they do is say, well, we don't have anything in Social Security. We're just borrowing the money. It's an IOU. And because they put it in the general fund, and they still do to this very day, that the money people pay in, it's not going into Social Security. It goes into the general fund, and they spend it. As a matter of fact, they spend it to the point where they spend over $1 trillion more than they take in.
Right.
They take the federal budget's nearly $4 trillion, and they only take in not quite $3
trillion. Yeah.
So where's it going to end?
Yeah.
You can't sustain that. It's not, as the kids say, these millennials, it's not sustainable.
Right.
That's what they say all the time. Right. It's not sustainable, and it won't be sustainable.
Right.
That's exactly what's going to happen is the bankruptcy of this country. And I'm telling you, if the oil producers in the Middle East and Europeans and the Chinese all get together in a collusion against the United States and they take the world economy off of the dollar, you're talking about chaos.
Oh, yeah.
What we got now is not going to be in any comparison to it. It's going to be crazy.
Yeah.
Because the dollar will plunge. It'll be worthless. You'll have massive inflation in this country. There won't be no quibble about getting your Social Security check because it'll be broke and you won't get one.
You think it'll be worse than the crash of the 20s?
It'll make that look like a picnic.
Yeah.
It's going to be bad. Unless you're growing your own food or hunting and fishing and getting your own food. People up in Alaska on these shows you watch, they're self-sustainable and they'll survive. They won't even notice it. But the people like us down here, we will notice it.
Oh,
it's going to be bad.
Yeah.
And I predict it's not going to be that much longer until all this goes down because the world's going to get tired of it.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Cuz we don't pay our bills.
Well, see, here's the thing about it, Dave. I wish that every American cared enough to go and look up. You can find it under the Organic Act of 1871. You can find it under the Corporation Act of 1871. When our federal government turned itself into a corporation to get itself out of debt, and it was signed by Ulysses S. Grant. Every one of them committed treason, David. Now, and why is that significant today? Because that is what got us in this hole. And then here in 1913 come the Emergency Banking Act. And then 1933 come the Fed.
Yeah, they took us off the gold standard and the silver standard. Now our money is practically worthless. And the Federal Reserve needs to be shut down. They need to do away with that organization completely. It has Who are they to dictate what the interest rate should be?
Right.
The market should dictate what the interest rate would be. And we wouldn't be in the trouble, half the trouble we're in right now, if the interest rates were where they should be. They artificially lowered them because, you know why? Because every time the interest rate goes up, the money that we pay in our taxes, like $400 billion just goes on the interest of the national debt.
Yeah.
That's a lot of money. Every time that interest rate goes up, that money, that payment goes up. So you have less money to spend. You have to borrow more from China, or you have to borrow more from Europe, or wherever they get it at, or print it, which during Obama's administration, they just printed more money.
Yeah.
So that's going to have to stop.
That's what you call fiat money, David. There's nothing to back that up. It's just pulled out of thin air. And every corporation, every business, sooner or later runs its course and it goes broke.
We're already there.
But the only thing we got left to do is just collapse. And our fate is in other people's hands, David. And people don't realize it. You know, people think, you know, that the government, you just keep shucking it out, shucking it out, shucking it out. Folks, that money that they're shucking out, when they run out of our money, Dave, then they borrow it from these bankers, European bankers, China, Japan.
You know what the Bible says? It says it's going to get so bad in the last days that it's going to take a day's wages just to feed yourself.
Yeah.
You won't be able to pay for the utility bill.
Right.
You won't be able to buy gas for your car. You won't be able to make a loan payment to have a car.
You're homeless.
Everything that you spend your money, all the money you make will go for food.
If you don't own your house, you're going to be homeless. If you don't have the money to pay your property tax, you're still homeless if you got that house paid off.
If it's massive, people take up arms and the sheriff can't, it goes to everybody and evict them if they start getting a shootout in every house in the block, can they?
They're not going to enforce the law when they.
That's right.
That
they won't. After you pick a few of them off trying to get on your land and take your house. Which will happen. Those who have the guns and the ammunition,
you know,
will do that.
Well, and you know, and just like Venezuela, and just like Cuba, and just like Mexico,
they always take your guns first.
Exactly.
They always
Germany,
take your guns first.
You think
Australia? They took the guns.
Australia.
South America, they take the guns.
South Africa, look at that.
They always the first thing they do. So, folks, watch out when they want to take your guns. You know what they want to do.
Then it's pure, but after they take your guns, then it's just total submission, or you die. And you know, human nature hasn't never changed, David. And for those with evil intentions, that's the bottom line to it. And you know, that takes me to Merkel.
Just think of poor old Jews in Germany, just talking about Merkel.
Yeah.
If the Jews in Germany had weapons and could have defended
themselves
and knew what was coming on, they could have defended themselves. It's better to die fighting than to die like a sheep.
It is. It is. I want you to listen to what Merkel said. Now, this was this year's article. And she said this. Nations must today be prepared to give up their sovereignty, according to German Chancellor Angela Merkel. Okay. Now, She's nothing but a globalist. She's an undercover.
It's
Hitler.
All of them, Les. All of them. I call them the three M's: Merkel,
France.
Merkel, May, and Macron.
Macron.
They're all
France.
The three M's. All of them's the same. They all got the same plan. And the people in Europe are rising up against it.
They're still going on.
That's why you're seeing in Paris
for 3 or 4 months.
They don't like what's going on.
Right, right, and it's not. See, people are saying, well, it's over the gas tax. It's not only over the gas tax, David. The immigration policy has as much to do. When your woman is raped in the street, when your daughters is raped in the street by these Muslim extremists.
When you can't go, there's no-go zones where the cops don't even go.
You're right, right. And that's in Paris, too.
I know it is. And that's crazy.
Yeah, yeah. And They're killing dogs, people's pets, because they don't want dogs around, and they're demanding that they that there's no pork or where they go. Well, I tell you what, and see, they started that in Australia too, Dave. And let me get my paper.
You know what,
here.
Though, Les? I seen this little kid fell into in the zoo, and a big rhinoceros was going to, a rhino was out nudging on him, and the parents grabbed the kid and pulled it back in. And you can see its shoe left behind.
Yeah.
And I said, what would those people in Venezuela do to see that big fat animal? They'd grab it, kill it, and eat it.
Yeah.
They'd eat it. They'd have to have a campfire going.
Oh, yeah.
They'd be roasting that big rhino.
They eat all of them in the zoo.
They've ate every one of them. I said, what a big piece of meat for them to eat.
Oh, man, yeah. They'd have it eat before it hit the ground. But now this Sebastian Kurtz, I don't know how old he is. But now he's the chancellor of Austria. And, brother, he's shutting down mosques. He's done expelled two of their imams.
That's good.
And he says politicize Islam a radical political, let me try my place here, political Islam or radical bands. Well, I lost it again. What's the matter with me? Politicized Islam or radical tendencies have no place in our country, Mr. Kurtz says. And two imams already received deportation orders. Another 60 is under investigation. A number of mosques were shut down over suspicious links to Islamic extremism. Here's my thing, David. The Islam, plain Islam, just Islam. I don't care if you're radical or if you're just you believe in Islam. It it's not compatible with a civilized society, David. Especially here in America, it is not. If you don't become an American, if you don't become an Austrian, if you go to any other country you go to and you don't assimilate and you don't be one of them and adopt their customs and adopt their ways of life, you're incompatible.
That's right.
You know, so it's not that I'm bashing Muslims. I'm bashing Islam. That's not a religion, David. That is
it's just another form of devil worship.
It's what it is. Yeah, exactly.
That's all it is. Think about it.
There was a word I was thinking, but that took the words right out of my mouth.
If you worship the devil in any kind of way, that's the way to do it.
Well, okay, let's just compare that to Christianity right now.
Now, remember, not all Muslims are terrorists, but most terrorists are Muslims.
Yes,
think
exactly.
About that.
Yeah.
And if you seek to kill and destroy and take over, what's the Bible? What did Jesus Christ say about that?
Right.
The enemy comes but to steal, kill, and destroy.
Yes.
That's John 10:10. He says that. The enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy.
That's right.
And that's exactly what Islam does.
Yes. They dominate. They want to dominate.
They take and do away with your religion, insert their own religion.
Right.
They stolen your religion. They steal. They kill. And they destroy.
Yeah.
It's as simple as that.
Right.
I mean, it's not hard.
Well,
that's exactly what they do.
And not only that, and like I said, this is not Muslim bashing. This is telling the truth. This is telling the facts as it's played out on our television every day. The people that they kill, the people that they rape in France, and in, excuse me, everywhere they go.
Well, I'll tell you this. You don't hear about Presbyterians, you don't hear about Lutherans, you don't hear about Methodists, you don't hear about Catholics, or you don't hear about Pentecostals or Baptists. You don't hear about them hijacking planes, killing people.
Right.
You don't hear about them blowing themselves up.
Yeah.
You don't hear them saying Jesus Christ is great and setting a bomb off.
Right.
You don't hear that stuff.
Right.
You do hear Allahu Akbar,
yeah.
God is great,
yeah.
Right before they blow themselves up or stab somebody
or
shoot somebody.
Crowd.
That's what they do.
Yeah.
They just did it recently.
Right.
So people ought to be trained when they hear Allah
they pull out their gun and shoot them right there before they do anything.
That's exactly
because that's
right.
what you got to do to them.
That's exactly
you gotta
right. That's the only thing
you
got to
pop them. I tell you, it's
and the Bible also says violence begets violence.
But you got to do it,
and that's why
you got to protect yourself.
And you know, self-defense is not murder.
No, it's not.
So this Sebastian Kurz, brother, he's putting his foot down. But the UN don't like it. No, they don't. They, you know, the UN leaders
Those
is coming out
crazy.
Against him. You
they
know.
Are. They're nuts. The UN's
and,
nuts.
Well, they're a bunch of globalists, David. They want this. They want control of America. They want control of the American people. They want control of America's wealth because their way of life and what they're doing. Look at their own countries, and the UN of all people. On their Human Rights Council, who other than North Korea do they have sitting in that council? What kind of people are these? What kind of people is... That's just like this border thing going on right here in America, David. What kind of people... And Bloomberg pardoned a bunch of illegals that was in prison in New York. Como, I'm sorry. What's the difference? Como, and one of them was a convicted murderer. Now, what kind of mindset, what kind of idiot are you, what kind of demonic spirit has possessed you to release these people, even murderers, back out on your own population? And, Dave, I can't...
But, you know, Les, thank God we got freedom of speech here in this country, because me and you couldn't say that. What we just said, we couldn't say that everywhere
right.
in the world.
Couldn't say it nowhere
but
other than America.
Aren't you glad we can say that here
Absolutely.
In America?
Yeah,
and nobody smuzzles us, or nobody...
Except Zuckerberg.
Nobody puts a gag on us, but we can say what we believe.
Except Zuckerberg.
Isn't that great?
Yeah.
Freedom is great.
There's many of people like me and you that's regulars at Zuckerberg's jail. And if he sat down and listened to one of our shows...
He'd agree with us 100%.
Know, inside, the boy's a Jew. What's he doing siding with Muslims? What's he doing siding with
they
the
would,
globalists?
They would love to cut his head off.
Well, sure they would. And he's
and
too
they'd love
stupid
to cut my head
know
off,
it.
And they'd love to cut your head off.
Well, sure they would. It'd take them a while. I got a thick neck.
No, they get a sharper knife. It
yeah.
won't take them just as long as it would mine. They just sharpen their knife a little bit sharp.
But now, see, these things are truth, David. Now, here's the thing about truth. Just because, now we're a little bit off of my subject here, but this is good. Here's the thing about truth, David. It doesn't matter what I believe. It doesn't make no difference what I think. If it's not based on the facts of reality, it ain't truth, David. It don't make no difference how many times I say it. It don't make no difference how many times I repeat it. It don't make no difference how many times you hear it. A lie is a lie. You cannot change the truth. The truth will stand when this world's on fire. The truth is going to stand, Dave.
Yeah, that's
connection lost.
Then you can't believe God.
Right.
And God says, thou shalt not kill.
Right.
And if you say, thou shalt not kill, and you go around blowing yourself up and killing people,
right.
or stabbing them, or running over them with a truck or a car,
right.
and you know, hijacking airplanes, running them into buildings, flying them into buildings.
What That's outright murder
what,
right there.
What kind of truth is that?
Right.
And they say, well, these are radical Muslims. No. That's par for the course.
Right.
If you read the Quran, I have read some of it, not all of it, but it...
You kill the infidels.
It teaches about either the infidels convert to Islam or they should be killed.
Right.
And they don't care which, really. It doesn't make any
doesn't
difference
to them.
If you kill them or if you convert them, it doesn't make much difference to them at all.
Right.
So what is... We have to know truth. And people say, well, everybody, you can do anything. You can lead, all paths lead to God.
Right.
Well, it doesn't
matter
if you're
right.
a Buddhist, a Hindu, a Muslim.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter. Well, it does matter.
It does matter.
And one day, everybody's going to find out that it does matter.
Yeah. Well, I tell you what, man, it's pitiful. Now, folks, y'all listening to us on Armed Radio, and let's come on to Dave here. And, you know, call in, folks. And for you guys out there in Cyberland, our number is 1-800-508-5431. And if you disagree with us, call in here. If you're a Muslim and you don't like what we say, call in and defend yourself.
They'll be more likely to turn you in.
Yeah, right. Yeah, well, you know, some of them on Facebook, you know, so they say last time I heard from him, it was on Armed Radio because Zuckerberg done put me back in jail. And but they do censor you. It's not their company policy. They call it what they want to censor.
I like it. They censored Franklin Graham. And they said, oh, we didn't mean to. Yeah, we made a mistake.
Yeah,
isn't that funny how they're found out? They always say, oh, no, we didn't mean to do that. We made a mistake.
Right.
Well, Franklin Graham was on Fox News. He kind of laughed about it because he was put in jail.
Right.
Because he had said, this is something he said years ago. I can't remember exactly what he said, but it was the truth.
Right.
He don't lie.
If he said it, it was a truth.
And they kicked him off of Facebook or Instagram or one of them.
Facebook. Oh, Zuckerberg guy. Yeah. But see, let's go back to Romney here for a minute. We get rid of Flake. Okay. And Mitt Romney, he's one of the elites. They people in Utah put him right back in office. He's a phony. He's a never-Trumper. He don't care about, I don't believe he cares one bit about this country. He's an elitist. And, a lot of people say, well, he's rich and all that. I don't care if he's poor as a church mouse. Okay? The thing about it is, we didn't need him in office. That's like sending John Kasich up there to Congress. What good does it do to send people like that back to Congress? They're deceivers, Dave. They are deceivers, they are, to get in office.
I heard Kasich's thinking about running against Trump, trying to get that would be a joke.
I tell you what.
Trump will chew him up and spit him out into tiny little pieces, and you'll never see him again. Because he will be indistinguishable.
Yeah.
He will destroy him. And I don't understand these people that are anti-Trumpers.
I don't get
it. Get the idea that he's doing every policy that you like. What's wrong with his policy? What's wrong with his doctrine? He has no problem with his policy or doctrine.
I've seen this. This black man interviewed this kid on Facebook. I've seen a 10-minute clip of it, I guess. And the only thing this kid could tell that black guy, well, Trump is a liar. He's a fascist. So the black guy said, well, me as a black man, he was a Trump supporter. I can't think of his name. He said, you tell me how that Trump's hurting me. This kid, he done nothing, but he stumbled all over himself, Dave. The willful ignorance in this millennial generation, it boggles my mind. They go to college, they're indoctrinated. Before they even get to college, in high school, they're indoctrinated. And the media indoctrinates people. And it's just, I've tried several times to figure out how did this hostile takeover happen to where the liberals wound up with every one of our great institutions, and now look at what they're producing.
Because, I'll tell you why, because the natural scheme of things is for people to devolve, not evolve into greater and good, but to devolve into evil. And that's exactly what this country's done. It's gone from believing in God overwhelmingly to, it's about 50-50 now.
Yeah.
And homosexual marriage, same way. It started out to be way people against it, like 75% of the people were against it.
Right.
Now it's about 50-50. Mm-hmm. And that's exactly where we are, even in the politics.
And going down.
And it will never improve until people's hearts change.
Until they
get right with their God and what's right and wrong. There is a right and a wrong.
And
I'm tired of people saying, well, if it doesn't hurt anybody, it's okay.
Yeah.
Well, that's not true.
Right.
It does hurt people. It hurts their soul. If you think all this stuff is legal and right to do, like abortion, homosexual marriage, the marijuana legalization, all these things that we've devolved into, which used to be totally wrong, have become right. Where is this country going to go? Mm-hmm. It can only go down.
Yeah.
And if you look at polls, that's exactly where it's going. It's going down.
Well, history tells you that, David. History tells you that. And when you will revert back to your humanity, and that will always steer you down the wrong path. And you see that immediately. The first thing that happened to the Hebrew children, they get to the Red Sea, and they're looking back. They're already wanting to go back. And into Egypt. And I said, what'd you do, Moses? Bring us out here for them to kill us? And then, mm-hmm. then what'd you do? Bring us out here to starve us to death?
They missed the herbs and the spices and the meat. They said, all we got is this lousy manna.
Yeah, yeah.
And so what's God do? He said, gives them quail. He blows, cause the wind to blow and blows them in. And there's just all kinds of meat.
Yeah.
And they eat so much meat, it's coming out their ears.
Yeah.
And they got tired of that.
Right.
So everything that God does for them, they get tired of it.
Well, see, and that's why that you see that the sin is on the increase, because nothing's satisfying. And that brings me to this point. I never was so angry and sick in a long time as when I seen this 10 or 11-year-old little boy dressed up like a drag queen. They had him on television, one of these liberal talk shows, had him on television, and his parents promoting this stuff, had him in some kind of a gay club, and he's up there dancing, they're giving him money, and he's up there, you know, doing his little routine.
Did you hear the latest?
Oh, my goodness.
As of the first, there's several states now that you can be a male, a female, or X.
Yeah. Well, New York's one of them. They done did it.
You can be, well, I don't know what X is.
I
thought there was only two choices, but there's a third choice, and I don't know what it is, and I don't think anybody else knows what it is.
Yeah.
It's just something you can put on the birth certificate.
Well, see here, Dave, what this boils down to is what it's always boiled down to, and that's the battle between right and wrong. It's the epic battle of good and evil. And you know, and here's a thought. You know, you play cowboys and Indians when you're a kid. You watch wrestling. Okay, you see wrestling. You got good guys and you got bad guys. You got predators and you got prey. Everything that you see, and everywhere you look, it's good versus evil. Everywhere you look.
Exactly right. The bottom line is, it's a choice between the devil and God.
Yeah.
And think about this for a second. I said, I was kind of rough on Muslims a little bit ago when I said it's of the devil. But think about this. If you, most Muslims are Democrats.
Mm-hmm.
Think about that. Have you ever wondered why? Because Islam doesn't teach in homosexuality.
Right.
And it doesn't teach on abortion. These doctrines are doctrines of devil.
Right,
of devils. And Islam doesn't teach this, but yet, why did they vote Democrat?
I don't know.
Because they have the same father, the devil.
Yeah, yeah.
That's why, and they don't even know it.
Yeah.
That's the bad
part. You're right about
that, brother. They don't even know it. That's the sad part about it, is that if they knew what they were doing, they would never do that.
Right. Well, it's willful ignorance is what it is. And that's just like these millennials that they show. Now, you know, and I don't paint all of them with the broad brush. There's a lot of youth that's conservative. But now,
I remember
for
Saddam.
The most part, they're not.
Remember Saddam Hussein? He would tie gay guys up.
Oh, yeah.
He would tie them up and roll them off of roofs.
Throw them off the roof.
And torture them and be mean to them and kill them. And this was done for sport.
Oh, yeah.
Entertainment. Homosexuals in this country, they take no thought about that.
Right.
They're one of us.
You know, here's the thing about it, Dave. There's nobody wanting to persecute even the church. And me and you stand against homosexuality and the perversion of that. But me and you would never advocate violence against the homosexual community. We love them just as much as we do our own brothers and sisters. It ain't about that, Dave.
Even Muslims, they don't know that, but if they knew the truth, they would never do what they do now.
Yeah.
They wouldn't. But the truth is, Jesus Christ, he said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come to God, or woman, for that matter, unless it's through him.
Right.
And once you get born again by his spirit, you know what's wrong. You know what's right.
Right.
Because the flesh, you don't know. You don't know what's right in yourself. You might have an idea of what you think is right and wrong, but until you read the book, which is the Bible, and you read about the Spirit of God and the Spirit of God in you and how it changes your life, that's being born again. And then you really know.
Right,
but
yeah.
It's sad that people don't know these things.
Well, Dave, most people don't. They just, it's just like me and you used to be, Dave. If it felt good, we done it. You know, we just went after it, you know. And we was concerned about our flesh man. You know, we was concerned about the wrong guy.
Well, you feed the flesh and you starve the spirit. That's what you do. Whatever you feed is going to grow stronger.
And but like I said before, I come the long road to get where I'm at. But I found out that there's a lot more joy and peace and happiness in life when it's not gobbled up and not clogged up, and when it's not mired in all the things that are killing us, Dave. And that's something else. You know, look at all the things that we used to do. It was taking days off of our life, you know. And, you know, we give those things up because of that. Because it wasn't right to start with in the first place. But in the second place, you know, we was actually killing ourselves before our time. Bible says you can add to your or shorten your days. And we do that by our lifestyle, the things that we do. You know, and, you know, but I find life a lot easier to live in the condition that I'm in now spiritually. You know what I'm saying?
Well, that's just the way most people, they don't take any thought about their life. They really don't. They just live life and whatever happens, happens. But there will come a day, though, and we'll all stand before God and we'll be judged.
Yeah.
And if whether you believe it or not, it will happen.
Right.
It's irrelevant what you believe about that, but it will happen. There will come a day of judgment, and there will become a day of that there will be a separation from God, or you'll be with God.
Well, here's the thing too, Dave. Okay, how many times does people wake up and before they get their day started, they're thinking, man, is this all there are to it? Is this it? You know, they have nothing to look forward to. There's no drive to go out there and do something for somebody else. And as a Christian, I can wake up and first of all and thank the Lord that I woke up. And if I didn't, I can't lose anyway, so it don't make no difference. But I start my day, Dave. I'm happy to see that day because that's another opportunity for me to maybe help somebody else. Maybe I can say something or do something to change somebody else's life. Maybe I can say something to cause people to think, you know, hey, there's more to this than just merely existing, you know. And Paul said himself, he said, man, if and I'll use my own words, he said, if there was no heaven or no hell, if this was all there was, he said, I'd be of all men most miserable, you know. And so Christian people have so much to look forward to, Dave, and not only look forward to the kingdom of God, but we realize that others are just as significant as what we are. And we're sent out there as Christians to minister to these people. And it ain't standing there shaking your finger in their face and telling them they're going to hell. It's to be there to help, you know. how many times has the Lord, you set out to go somewhere and or to do something, and you find yourself talking to somebody that's broken or talking to somebody with problems or helping somebody, helps changing a flat tire, you know, helping some old woman load groceries. And you know, a lot of people say, well, anybody can do that. Well, sure you can. Why don't, you know, we live in such a mean society today, David.
Well, Jesus said this. He says, the lamp of the body is the eye. If therefore your eye is good, your whole body will be good, full of light. But if your eye is bad, your whole body will be full of darkness. If therefore the light that is in you is darkness, how great is that darkness? For no one can serve two masters, for he either will hate one and love the other, or else will be loyal to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon, or money, or anything else that you put in front of God.
Or yourself.
You can't serve them both. Therefore, he says, I say to you, don't worry about your life, or what you will eat, or what you will drink, or what about your body, what you will put on. For is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds in the air, for they neither sow nor reap, or gather into barns. Yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they? Which of you, by worrying, could add one cubit to his stature? So why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow, neither toil nor spin. And yet I say unto you, that even Solomon in all of his glory was not arrayed as one of these. Now if God clothes the grass of the field, which is today is, and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith? And that's,
Amen,
that's Jesus,
bro,
Christ speaking there in a sermon. And that's so true, and that's what the world gets caught up in, is seeking things.
Things
will not satisfy you. They'll never satisfy
you. Right.
Things never do. I don't care what it is, drugs, alcohol, sex, or anything.
It runs its course, Dave. That's just like a new car. Okay. When you buy a new car, boy, you park that thing out in the center of the parking lot where there's nobody around. You don't smoke in it. You don't eat in it. You don't drink in it. Well, that lasts about 3 months. And then you're parking a little closer to the door. Go ahead, roll the window down a little bit. You could smoke in here. Or you're driving down the road yourself eating a big old Wendy's cheeseburger or something. And because it don't last. There's nothing. That new car smell is only going to last so long. And that goes for everything, Dave. Everything we go at, we, as humans, we get bored with that. But here's the thing. You know, with the manner of people that we are now in the body of Christ, it's no longer, it's just like when I had kids, Dave. Okay, before I had kids, me and wife, okay, our life was just about me and her. Okay, mainly just me and her to go do whatever we want. But once we had kids, brother, everything changed. It wasn't about us anymore. It was about those kids and how we would sacrifice and go out of our way, even do without, to take care of those kids. And it's akin to getting saved and receiving the Lord as your personal Savior. You know, once you do that, you know your life, it's not all about you anymore. Okay, once you receive the Lord, you're secure, Dave. You have secured your place in heaven. Now, you just got to listen to that small, still voice, and you got to seek God. Jesus said, if you seek, you'll find. If you knock, it'll be opened unto you. And then your life becomes not so much about yourself, David, but what can I do for somebody else? What can I do for the church? What can I do for my neighbor? What can I do? God, where you want me to go? God, what do you want me to do? And that is so satisfying. That is so fulfilling because, see, it's different. Every day that I live with Christ, it's a different day, Dave. I go through my routine. I do a lot of things the same. But, you know, just about every day, there's something different in there. There's something coming at me different. I'll hear something different. Something, a light will come on, and hey, you know what? That's what that means. This is what that's all about. Life is so much of a joy to live now because, see, I'm secure, Dave. I've laid my treasures up in heaven. I'm okay. I'm took care of. Sure, I got my battles. I got my shortcomings. Okay, I've got all these problems that I have to deal with. But what did you just read? I don't have to be consumed by them things, David. All I got to do is be obedient to God and follow after the things that God wants me to do. And you know what? I don't have to worry about those other things.
I heard something on the radio today. Said that some, I don't know what part of the United States it was, or even if it was the United States.
Pass the plate here. Hold on.
This particular bird, I can't remember the name of it, they said it was extinct. It was now extinct. I said, well, why is that? Why would a bird become extinct? What could we have done to it to cause it to go extinct? Can a bird fly? They can. If we take and cut its tree down, can it find another tree?
Right.
And build a nest? What would cause a bird to go extinct? I said, well, that scripture I read, it said, consider the birds of the air. They either toil or reap, or they put away in their barns anything. But yet God takes care of them.
Sure.
So why is it that a bird would go extinct? Well, it's just a natural course of nature, probably.
Yeah.
But there's been many species go extinct over the years.
And we found new species also.
And we found them. But it's not our fault. Right. Everything is blamed on man. That we,
old man.
That we cause global warming, that we cause, it's because the people that say these things worship the creation and not the creator.
Right.
But the world will last as long as it needs to last.
Right.
Because God promised that.
Yeah.
And it's not going to, we're not going to destroy it. There's no way we can.
If this was an accident, how come every living thing, even the plants, how come that this world provides everything with everything it needs?
Right. Well, even with all of our
even
with all of our technology, if we came about on this earth by accident, why can't we recreate it with all of our technology?
Why can't we recreate it?
We can't. We can't make life. We can't create life. There's no way we can. Even a single cell is so complicated and complex that we can't even begin to understand it.
Right.
We don't know the metabolism of it. We don't know all the chemical reactions that take place within that cell.
It can't be recreated.
Or what goes wrong when cancer hits that cell. We don't understand what trips that. We're beginning to, you know, just scrape the ice a little bit of the surface of it. But we don't know. That's just it. We don't know. And God knows because He made us. We're complex beings.
Why do we have why does everybody have different fingerprints? You know, even my aunt's got triplets. You know all three of them, and you know them. They all three got different fingerprints.
I've never fingerprinted them.
Well,
I don't know.
But science will tell you that that's a fact, that they don't have the same fingerprints.
I don't know, but that's something, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
God loves variety.
You know, and, you know, it's just, like, I've preached this, I've talked it, for years, David, is name me one thing that man created out of nothing. Not one thing has he pulled out of thin air, you know, unless the government's doing money.
That God spoke everything into existence.
Well, you know, and I've said this
everything.
A million times, Dave. If this was an accident, how come this earth produces everything we see, wear, eat, everything that we... You know, all our clothes, everything, even the cars we drive, the bicycles we ride, everything, telephones, everything comes from this earth in one form or another, and we just had to figure out how to put it together.
Can you see God's pattern, though, in everything that
He does?
Well,
certainly.
Look up at in a universe. Look at a spiral galaxy. What does that remind you of? It reminds you of a hurricane.
Yeah, right.
When you look at it, it looks like a hurricane.
Yeah.
But that's a pattern of God. He made everything in a pattern.
Sure.
All the planets are round. The sun is round, which is a star. The earth is round. God knew it was round before anybody said the earth was... Many people said the earth was flat. But
yeah,
others said it's round.
Society.
So
But we know the earth is round because the Bible told us.
Right.
And plus we can look up at the moon and we know that it's round.
Looks round.
Why would the moon be round and we not be round?
Yeah.
Everything's round. That's a pattern that God made. Right. And everything is a pattern. Everything has a mate.
Right.
And everything, all species have mates.
Right.
That's the way God made
they,
us.
They reproduce after their own kind.
It's not male with male and female
after
with female.
After your own kind,
they have their own species.
That's right. You know, we got a couple minutes left here, Dave, but, you know, that's if you're listening to us for the first time, I mean, this can happen on our show. We go from politics right into the Word of God. And, you know, I don't call that a religion, David. I call that a relationship.
That's good. I like that. That's good.
You know, and I tell you what, you can't explain it. You just have to experience it, Dave, you know. Christianity is something that that you can feel. It's something you can know. It's something that you can be sure of.
You know, I heard somebody put it this way. All the other religions of the world, it's what you do for that religion.
Right.
But with Christianity, it's what God has done for you.
Amen, brother. That's good.
And
care.
That's what He's done for us, is sent us His Son, Jesus Christ, and we just celebrated His birthday.
Absolutely.
A couple weeks ago. But this is what it's all about.
Absolutely.
Serving God and serving God through His Son,
all
Jesus
right.
Christ.
Hey, Jimmy, I got about 30 seconds on my timer, brother, and we're going to say good night to everybody. And we appreciate Nancy leave the Facebook on. I see we got some people still with us. And out there in cyber land, Dave.
So we get thrown off of Facebook.
Yeah.
for a Muslim comment, I guess. What did I say? They were a religion of the devil?
That's what you said. Hey, God bless everybody out there in radio land. Appreciate you listening. We love you. Jesus loves you, and I hope you enjoyed this show, and we'll see you on Armed Radio next week, same time, same channel. Jimmy, take us out, my brother. The moon, kids going up soon. Politicians say more taxes will solve everything. And the band plays.